So going back to our choices for reducing the AMAT, we have seen that we can reduce the hit time. We have now seen that there are techniques that reduce the miss rate. And the final set of techniques are those that reduce the miss penalty. So when we miss, we don't suffer as much as before. So the first technique for reducing the miss penalty is to overlap multiple misses. If time goes in this direction, our processor does a lot of activity, multiple instructions per cycle, and at some point it does a load, for example, and now that load tries to be found in the cache, and if not, we're gonna go to memory and it eventually comes back. Now, if you have a fancy out-of-order processor, it doesn't stop here and wait. What it does is it finds other instructions to do. So even after we start fetching the data from memory, the processor is continuing. But eventually, it starts running out of things to do, and probably before the load comes back from memory, the processor runs out of resources. Remember that it cannot commit this load, so eventually, for example, it will fill up the ROB, or maybe even sooner than that, it will run out of reservation stations if a lot of things depend on this load. So some part of this miss latency is going to be directly added to the execution time, but some part of it is actually overlapping with the processor activity. During the time between trying to execute this load and running out of things to do, this processor might actually issue another load that would be a cache miss. So if we have what is called a blocking cache, then this load cannot be done until the first load is finished. And only at this point, this load can really be tried in the cache. We realize it's a miss. We suffer the miss latency. And meanwhile, because the processor can commit these instructions here, the processor can overlap some of this miss latency with some other activity. We can also have a non-blocking cache. And a non-blocking cache can support things like hit under a miss, meaning while we are having a cache miss, hits to other blocks in the cache that are sent by the processor will be serviced and returned to the processor with data. And also we can have what is called a miss under a miss, in which case, while we are having a miss, we can send another request to memory. So let's look at what that looks like. So our processor is happily chugging along. It has this first load that suffers a miss. We check in the cache. We wait for it to come back from memory. We continue working and eventually run out of things to do because they depend on this first load. But the idea is that now this load here that also suffers a miss will have its own check in the cache. And when we realize it's a miss, we will send it to memory so it will come back here. Now what we have is when the first load comes back from memory, there is a burst of activity. It starts dying out because we're still waiting for the second load. But then the second load comes back and we are very quickly back to our normal operation. So now, as you can see, the inactivity in the processor used to be this and this, and now it's just this and maybe a small amount here. So by overlapping the miss time of the two loads, we have almost cut the penalty on performance to half of what it was. Because before we had to wait twice this, now we really wait once and maybe some little more. If we manage to find three or four loads that overlap, then with a blocking cache, we would pay the penalty three or four times. Here, we might be paying one penalty plus a little bit more. The property that the processor is exploiting here is called memory level parallelism. Here, the memory never gets more than one access at a time. Here, the memory gets accesses to process them in parallel. So, of course, our memory needs to be able to do this, but if it can, then a non-blocking cache that can do miss under miss can dramatically cut down on the cost of misses. Instead of seeing the full miss latency being added to the memory access time, we are really seeing that the penalties of the two misses overlap. So really we pay the penalty once and we get 1, 2, 15 misses in exchange.